Assalamu alaikum. Hey guys, today I am coming with another video. So in this tutorial we are going to learn how to create a bridge. Okay, for example, and also I will show you how can create surface from random elevation. Okay, so first of all I create a new page from here, brand new page. Okay, then I type from my keyboard PL, hit enter. So x y is suppose 0, 0, hit enter. So this is my 0 point. Okay, this is my reference point. So I want to suppose give the length of surface or width, suppose I keep 100 meter, hit enter, and then this is the height. Okay, and then I'll give 300 meter, and coming down again 100 meter, and for close type C from your keyboard and hit enter. So this is the polyline box. So if you want to check, there is no elevation right now. Okay, properties, see, the elevation is 0, everything is 0, 0. So I want to put elevation. So this is the before I give the elevation, I can convert this polyline to future line. Okay, first of all, here is the future line. Click the drop down button and then create future line from object. Choose this button. Also you can create site or keep as it is. So also you can change name or extra style. So I keep as it is everything. Also here RS adjusting entities, check this, or you can check. So assign elevation. Okay, check assign elevation, click OK. Here it is. Also you can take surface from the from the ground level, from the top of from your site, but this is the way I want to show you how can you create your own surface for practice. Okay, so I give the elevation, so, suppose like 635.250. okay, and then click OK. So now I have the surface. If I want to check, I click the future line and coming here the elevation editor, click like this. So there you can find the elevation. Okay, so now click OK. Now I have elevation, but I need, because I want to create a bridge, that's why I want to put elevation different, because I want to in the center I want to down this area from here and here. Okay, this two side is should be up and the middle side should be down. Okay, for bridge. So how I create this? Now I am going to insert PI, point of intersect. Okay, suppose I create over here one, and then it will ask me for elevation. So I can give elevation suppose 634.50, hit enter. Remember this elevation. Okay, and then draw once here. same elevation you entered before, 634.50 enter. Okay, now I want to create another one here, the same elevation I enter. Okay, 634.50, and then another one is here, 634.50, hit enter. Now almost my elevation is done. See, I have now here and the 4 point extra. Okay, so now I need two more points for this is the slope point, and I need two more points. Okay, I'll create this four more points later. So I have to create a street like this at this point. Take here, take this also like this. Also you can create a line, no problem, you can create line. And okay, put over the line, same line, copy and okay. So I need two more points, four more points. Suppose I create a line from here to here. This is not a straight, okay. So what I'm going to do, I just make it straight and same thing. Now I am giving the offset from this line, suppose 10 meter from here to here and here to here. Okay, so I have to create points over here, one, and asking for elevation. This time I am going to give the elevation 6-3, no, going to 622.5. okay, remember the elevation. Okay, the same thing in this side also, 622.5, and this side also 6. You can give different elevation, no problem. Okay, for practice, this is only for practice. Whatever you want, you can give the elevation 622.5. Suppose I give 30, hit enter. My elevation is done right now. So I move this polyline or keep as it is, no problem. I can use this later. So I am to draw right now polyline for polyline for center line alignment like this. Click and end of my surface. This is my polyline. So I am going to draw the alignment. Before I create alignment, I should create surface. Okay, also you can create alignment, and after alignment you can create surface, no problem. So I just click my future line, and then here it is the option grading creation tools or create surface. So I want to create surface. I just click the create surface like this. You can create surface several way. Okay, this is the another way. So you can give the name or keep as it is. So I keep as it is. Right now here the tool space, you can find here surface plus expand, and there it is, surface one. Okay, so expand the plus sign, and then coming definition. Click the plus sign and coming to here, break lines. So click right button and add. So this is, if you want to give the description, you can give, otherwise keep as it is. Okay, so I just click OK. See, my surface is done right now. Here it is. If I select my surface and then coming to object viewer, or object viewer you can coming also from here. So this is the realistic. So I'm coming here. I SW SmartX, just see my surface. Okay, I just check the style conceptual. Okay, see, this is my surface. This is the top level and this is the down level. Okay, so you can easily draw surface like this, which is random elevation for practice purpose. Also I can do this from topography, from site, your site, but for practice this is best. Okay, no problem. So now my surface is done. I'm going to create the alignment. Create alignment from object, select the polyline and hit enter from your keyboard. Also you can read from the comment bar. So select line arcs or polyline to create alignment. Okay, you can create alignment from lines, from arcs or polyline. Just hit enter from your keyboard. See the direction. Okay, you can reverse this from here. If you click reverse, it will reverse the arrow. So I just keep as it is at hit enter. So if you want to change the alignment name, you can change from here, or station, alignment style. So I just give the major and minor. This is the straight line. So there is no need the radius of curve. So I uncheck all of this. Just I need to erase my polyline. So keep check. Click OK. Before I click OK, I just want to change the station. Where is the station? Sorry, here. And to change the station 25 and 100 for tick. Okay, just click OK. Click OK. So this is my alignment right now. I am going to create profile from this alignment. Okay, coming to the profile option and then create surface profile. So there is my alignment 1 and surface 1. This is the stations, and then click add for surface. And now I am going to click draw profile. Keep as it is everything, or you can change if you want to. So click next, and so I just keep as it is everything. Click next, create profile view. So I just click here. See, this is my surface line. See, if you want to change this surface line, so you can change. See, select the surface and display send to back. Now this is your future line. If you want to change your elevation, you can change from here. Okay, you can change from here. Everything is changeable. After you change, you need to modify, update your surface, and it will be changed. So I just give some style for profile. Before I do this, I just need to change the graph like this. Okay. See. Also, I give the interval 25. Now it's look better. I need to change something. 4, 2. Okay. So this is better. Now I'm going to change the elevation. Band style. Coming to band style here. Just elevation 3 digit and change the color green. Okay, and what else? Change the FG color, give the red color. Okay, so keep check. Then change the surface, because I do not create profile designer. So click OK. Now my style is done, everything is done. This is the station existing level, and then this is the design level. Okay, so I am to create design. Just click the profile view, and then here profile creation tools coming, and then keep as it is, or you want to give name, you can give name, style as you like. So I just click OK. So I have to draw profile, draw tangent with curve. So I choose this, and then the first point I click here, and then second point is here, the third point is here. Remember, this is for just example, okay guys. This is not professional way design, but this is the way you can make design. Okay, so just keep little down. More. So this is the perfect design. Okay, now this is a perfect design. But this is the way you can design any bridge, any roads like this. Okay, so my profile is done. If you want to change check the name, you can check here, profile layout 1. So now you can see the leveler, both levelers same. So I want to change this. Just click select the profile view and click mouse right button and profile view properties, and coming here, this is the profile 1, is surface 1, okay, which is a natural ground level, and profile 2 is design level. Okay, see layout 1, select from here and click OK. Now you can see the design elevation is changed. Okay, which is this line. Now my surface and profile is done. Now I am going to create the corridor, and before a corridor I want to create assembly. So there is the section. Okay, and there is a corridor. This is the corridor option. There is the create assembly. So I want to just click shortcut command control 3 from your keyboard like this, control 3. So we will find the assembly tool palettes. Okay, so I am going to Okay, there is the basic lens. Before that, I just click again, create assembly. So if you want to give the name, you can give name or keep as it is. Click OK and create the assembly here. So I have to give the lens. This is the right one. Okay. This is a basic lens. I choose this is a basic lens. Or you can delete this. Just lens super elevation AOR. Just click the center. And okay, this is okay. So I need shoulder. Okay. I need to close all of these, and I just click the shoulder because I want to some edit. If you want to change anything, you can change anything from here or keep as it is. So I forget the set slope. Daylight, I want to put daylight here. Just select all the site and then mirror it for other site. So guys, you should change from you should change the lens as you want, like this. Select the lens and then change. Suppose there is a 3.6 one lens. Okay, I want to change it 7.30, and this is the shoulder. I want to change 1.5. Okay, so I just press and then select again. Mirror all. So my road assembly is done. Right now remaining is bridge, for bridge. Okay, so I'm going to click again, or I just copy this assembly CO from your keyboard and select the assembly and copy it down. So I just remove the daylight both side, and shoulder I need to change. So I just okay, I need to cancel the shoulder from here both side. Also, I want maybe I just remove the shoulder, no problem. I just remove, okay. And I just only keep the asphalt. Suppose, okay, this is the 5 cm asphalt, and everything is 0, 0. Just let and mirror. So this is the asphalt top of the bridge. Now I am call again control 3 for bridge. So this is the bridge. So there is a two options. There is breech box girder one, and then the under the this one breech box girder two, breech box girder one. Put same thing, same way. So now I want to move also this one. So keep down. So this is a perfect. Now just select and click mouse right button. Coming to the properties. If you want to change, you can change from here. First of all, I want to change the style code, code set style. Okay, from all I want to change in view edit. Okay, so this is better, I think, better to see everything. You can see everything right now. So I am going to change. You can change also slope. There is a 2% slope, or keep as it is. Or what else I want to change? Suppose overhang width. Also, I can change greater width. So suppose socket depth I want to give 2. So not, I just change to 1. So this is better, and then change again. Okay. So, but my asphalt, I want to increase my asphalt width, or you can decrease this width of box cupboard. Okay, or keep as it is, no problem. After you finish, you can modify this. Okay, now I am finished my two assemblies. So I need to check the name of my, so this is the assembly 2 and this is the 1. Okay, you should remember the name for assembly. So now I am going to create corridor. Just coming to corridor and create corridor from here, and no need to give any name, just keep as it is. You can change with your requirement. So I just keep everything as it is. So this is my profile design, which is this line, and this is the alignment, which is this one. And assembly, I need to check assembly. I have two assembly, which is assembly 1, assembly 2. Also, you can change assembly names from here. Okay, I first of all I just choose assembly 1, and then from target surface I just select the surface. Now I want to click OK button, and there is, so just click OK. Now my corridor is done. This is the only corridor, this one, number 1. I do not create yet the bridge corridor. The first one is done. Okay, if you want to check, you can check your object view what look like. This is the actual corridor. So now I am going to change from here. Suppose from here to here, bridge bridge assembly, which is box culvert. Okay, so first of all I just select my surf corridor, and then coming here is split region. Click like this. You can do this two ways. So this is the one of them. I want to just click anywhere, so choose the line we are creating from here. Okay, this is the joint of bridge from here. Okay, and I want to click again here, the joint from here. So center. Now my corridor is split. This is the separate. Now we can change the assembly anywhere we kept. So I just click the corridor again and coming to the parameter. So now we have three corridors. Also you can change assembly from here. So if you select C, see the screen, this is the middle one. We want to change assembly. Just change the assembly from 1 to 2. Bridge. See, our bridge is done, but we should decrease this width because our road is maybe 7.3, okay, 14.6 meter width our road. The bridge is maybe only 14 or 14.6 also, but there is the more. We should decrease the our width of this select and properties. C 17.80. You can change width like this. So this is actual width. Okay. If you want to remove this barrier, you can remove like this. Click. So the see the include barrier. Just come here and then omit barriers. So it will disappear. Okay. Also, you can change size from here, the barrier size. You can change from here, okay, if you want to. See, you can change everything. So this width also you can change. Suppose this is the greater width, which is girder width. This one is girder width. You can change from here 3. If you want to give more, you can change from here. Okay. So after I modify this thing, I need to rebuild my corridor. Then you will see the change here. Just click the rebuild. See, this is my bridge. Right now there is no daylight. If you want to check this thing to our view, object view, just click like this. So this is a bridge. Barrier, and this is the road. Click to realistic. So this is the realistic. See, okay. Also you can click to drive to check how is looking. So now I want to create something for some slope from the start of bridge and end of bridge. Okay, how we create this? So I just click PL for polyline. So this is our start of bridge from here, this line. Okay, just check the nearest points, so I can click anywhere I want. So I just click first one, this is my first point, and give the width suppose 10 meter or 5 meter, just type 5 meter. So this is my line. Another is give a straight line, and click here. So this is my polyline, normal polyline. Okay, so I want to mirror this for another side. Just click coming to the midpoint, suppose, okay, hit enter, just move a little bit. So my bridge is start from here. Now I want to create surface for corridor, because I want to elevation this elevation randomly like this. I just click the corridor, and coming to corridor, coming here the surface option, the surface, and then I'm coming to top of link, or I just I just click the top of link and click here drop link plus sign and check this and click the corridor extends as outer boundary, click OK, revealed. So my surface is done. This is my surface from corridor. Okay, so I want to give this elevation. I just select my corridor surface and coming here, add levels, spot elevation. So suppose I click here, this is the 635.5 elevation. Also I check here the same elevation, no, 635.48. okay, so I want to convert this little polyline to feature line. So I want to assign the elevation. Yes, 635.5. Suppose. Okay. Suppose. Click OK. So my feature line is done. Now I just click my feature line, and I don't need this elevation anymore. So I just click my feature line and start create grading creation tools. Click like this. First, select the surface you want. This is the surface one. And click OK. Click here. Grade to surface. And this one is the create grading. So click automatic surface area. Check. Check volume base surface and click OK. So if you want to create the grading group, you can change the name or keep as it is. Click OK. So there is the solicitor asking you select the feature. Okay, so I want to select this my line, and then solicitor will ask you select the grading site. So if you want to create inside, you can click inside, or if you want to grading in outside, you can just click outside like this. Okay, so it will asking you the apply to entire length. If you want to yes, you can just hit enter to yes. If you not, you just click no. Okay, so I want to click yes. So there is now slope. If you want to give the slope, you can give. Okay, or grading, you can just click the grade. So I want to give the slope, so I want to just click enter. There is a 2:1. If you want to change, you just type here like this and hit enter, or like this, hit enter, whatever slope you want. Okay, so I keep as it is, click enter. It will asking me again. Yes, I want to put same slope again. So now this my grading is done. Okay, and create grading, select the feature line. So if you want to continue again, you just continue from this, but this is not ready for grading because this is the only polyline. I need to convert this polyline to feature line. So I skip the option and then select the grading site to check object viewer. So it's okay. There is lots of way to grading this feature line. You can create assembly to grade your feature line. Also you can grade like this way. So I want to create another feature line. Okay. So I have my elevation here. So I have to just create grading, select my feature line, click outside. Yes, yes, same way. Okay. Now my grading is done. If I select one, it will select another one because these two grading is the same site. If you want to check, see the site one, future grading group is one grading group. Okay, that's why it will select. If you want click one, it will select another together. So now I click all the surface to check in object viewer how it's look like. So it's kind of okay for me. This is the bottom surface. Okay, and this is the top surface. This is the sea under the from under the bridge. You will find this concrete, lots of trees. You can see this in real life. Okay, so now you can create column from here to here. This is the way you can grading your. So if you want to create the column, you can just click the circle or make one box like this, rectangle like this, width of bridge. Okay, and just click move. Suppose resize this. Okay, now you can create foundation like normal AutoCAD command ext for extrude. Okay, just click like this and you can select the polyline and click enter. Give the value you want, suppose 1 meter height. Okay, also you need to give the elevation, suppose select line and click here for surface level. Okay, spot elevation. Select surface. No, this is the node surface. This is the surface. Spot elevation. 6 to 2.5. Okay, just give select this poly rectangle or just explode. Explode again. So now I want to join this. So before you create extrude, you should give the elevation, okay? Joint all of the line. Okay, right now click. So there is the elevation, 6 to 2.5. Okay, now we can extrude. Ext, hit enter, give the elevation 1 meter. Okay, I'll create the two vertical for check. Okay, see, you can see in 3D mode, you will find the foundation here. So I made one mistake. Before I give the elevation for this line, I create the extrude. So I want to delete this line again. Let this line also, I want to create suppose PL polyline 2 meter, so 4 meter, and 14.6. okay, 4 and C to enter. Now I give it to the elevation like 6 to 2.5. hit enter. Now it's okay. You will see the S box top of surface. Now I can create the circle. Two meter or 1 meter, no problem. Okay. So I'll just 1 meter. One is here, one is this side. So this is called center G, which is elevation, and to give the same elevation 6 to 2.5. okay, again 6 to 2.5. now you can see the two circle here. Okay, to extrude this circle, EXT, hit enter, select the circle and hit enter again, give the height you want. You will see there the changes. You can give the height height of your bridge level. Okay, suppose 12 meters. EXT, EXT. Okay, again hit enter, 12. You can adjust the diameter of your column like this. The elevation should be 6 to 2.5. Now it's done. You can see it's done. Okay, I'm coming to one view, maximize viewport. Now I want to just show you the exact bridge to drive and select crown. Click OK. Click the play button. So if you want to put anything, any block in this top of this bridge, you can put also. So I want to just infill this area. Perfect. Okay, just put some block top of this bridge. Suppose I have to give some blocks from I give this Mercedes, or if there is no Ferrari. Okay, I choose more series. I want to give this Mercedes elevation. Select this car. Before I do this, I need to confirm the elevation. Six three five point 48. So the same elevation. Just give the position Y. 65.5. Now you will see the 3D card here. I just copy this. Copy from here. Give this rotate. Okay, this is the Mercedes. Okay. Play. I forget this Mercedes, forget the elevation. So guys, this is the way you can create your bridge design. Okay, but this is the simple way. Also, we have lots of way to design the bridge. This is the one of them. I hope this video will be work. So thank you for watching, and Allah Hafiz.